Welcome you all in biology class. On the previous turn we have discussed about the fertilization. Now today we are going to discuss about the changes taking place after fertilization. After fertilization are different changes taking place in the flower and all the parts of the flower. That one is the except that ovary, all that wither away. We have to say that one is the petal, sepal, stamen, they all get fall off, okay? And the ovary, it enlarges to form the fruit. And the fertilized ovule, it form the seed, okay? Then seed, it contains the embryo, which develops into a baby plant. Now, we are moving towards the parts of flower. A ripe fruit, it consists of the pericarp and seed. What is that? Pericarp and seed. And the pericarp, it develops from the ovary wall. It develops from the ovary wall and it contains three parts. Pericarp, it contains three parts. Inner one, endocarp. Middle one, mesocarp. Then outer one, epicarp. Okay. So, epicarp, it is the outer layer, thin skin that covers the entire fruit. Mesocarp, middle one, edible layer of the fruit, and endocarp is the innermost layer that encloses the seed. Okay, these are the different parts of pericarp. Now we are moving towards the type of fruit. When we look toward the type of fruit, a single ovary, it form a ovary of a flower, it form a single fruit, one fruit, that is known as the simple fruit. And it is of two types, dry and fleshy. Okay. That one is the, in dry fruits, the entire pericarp becomes dry at maturity and it cannot be differentiated epicarp into the mesocarp, endocarp, that one is. And examples, dry fruits, aapke, that one is the pea and walnuts. And when we look toward the fleshy fruit, that one is developed into succulent tissue. It is soft and fleshy at maturity and can be differentiated into outer epicarp, middle mesocarp, and then the endocarp. These are different layers in it. That one is the fleshy fruit. Example, mango, bananas, etc. Now, parts of seed. In flowering plant, seeds are enclosed within the fruit and a seed, it contains the embryo which gives rise to new plant after germination and it contains a outer layer, that one is the seed coat. Seed coat, look towards the different parts of flower, seed, you are able to get the outer part, that one is the seed coat, okay? Seed coat, outer protective layer of a seed, it protect the inner part of a seed as well as it absorb water to soften and can break open at the time of germination. And water, it enters through the small opening. That opening is known as the micropyle. From here you are able to get. From where the water absorb water, that your seed absorb water, that one is through the micropyle. Okay. Then we are looking toward the parts of embryo. That one is the radical and plumule. It is a part of the seed that develops from the zygote. Radical, it gives rise to the root system, and plumule, it gives rise to the shoot system. Okay. So, that one is the structure of seed that you have to draw it in your notebook also. Then, seed, it contains the seed leaves, cotyledon that surround embryo and nourish the seedling during germination. That one is seed with one cotyledon. When the seed is divided into two equal halves, that one is known as the dicot seed, and which contains only single cotyledon. That one is monocot, like that one is the example, maize and rice, okay? And two cotyledon, like the pea, we are able to divide the seed into two parts. That one is the dicot seed. And endosperm, that one is lies just beneath the seed coat. It provides the food to the embryo. Endosperm, it persists in the monocot seed and it gets reduced in the dicot. So this is all for today's class. And we will meet on the next turn. Thank you. Have a nice day.